For you, I've got a quickie unboxing video and a quickie gameplay video, and I'm just going to go ahead and jump right to it. I just received this in the mail yesterday, last night after I got off work. Unfortunately, my wife thought it was for her, and she opened the box already. But anyways, it's Targa, also known as Rendering Ranger in Japan. This was originally released in Japan as a limited release because the designer and creator, Manfred Trenz, he worked on R-Type and Turrican for the Commodore, and you may be more familiar with Super R-Type and Super Turrican for the Super Nintendo. Targa here was originally going to be released as Targa in Japan and America, but he worked on it for a long time. He changed the graphics from like hand-drawn graphics to rendering, a pre-rendered type of graphics similar to Donkey Kong, I believe, and I guess that's why they changed the name to Rendering Ranger. And but he worked on it for so long that eventually time was up for the Super Nintendo. I guess it was late in the release, nobody wanted to pick it up, and it just didn't get sold in America, even though the Japanese version is still in English mostly. Here is a brand new game for the Super Nintendo in America, released finally, Targa. Comes in this nice, shiny clamshell box, or as they call it, a bit box. And it's nice. It's plastic, hard plastic. It's like those Disney cases that you used to get for VHSs. I really like this. Could you imagine if like all Nintendo and Super Nintendo games would have come in this? How many people would still have their boxes? Anyways, on the inside, a beautiful shiny inside and shiny cart. Comes with this little nifty poster. Targa, and my copy is number 51 from the guy who made this cart specifically. Then the cart itself is pretty unique as well. You can see it looks like a Famicom cart, Super Famicom cart, more so than a Super Nintendo cart. And the guy that made this, it was purely out of design for him. He thought it looked nicer, and he said it was more sturdy. It feels really sturdy, feels real nice hard plastic. What is also special is the PCB, the computer board, is brand new. This is not a repro cart. The shell is brand new molding. He programmed this on a new board. It did not come from another game, which I find is pretty special. So the only game that's ever been on this board particularly is Targa. And so that's pretty neat. And the guy that made him, Mr. Mark 0673 on Nintendo Age, is the guy selling the Targa on Nintendo Age, of course. And he's doing I'm not sure how many he's going to sell. He might be doing a limited release of these as well. I'm not sure, so I went ahead and snagged one at the price of $85. And the reason why it's so expensive is because he did use all new products, you know, new shell, new board, and you know, he spent money on printing the nice label here on the front, and the poster, and the shell, and the bit box, as he calls it. But it, you know, it's pretty cool, and I think it's nice to have. I'm not huge into buying repro games. I did buy one, and I was really disappointed with it, Zelda Parallel Worlds. I kind of regret buying that one, but what I don't regret buying when I do get a repro is the Japanese releases that were never released in America, because you know, some of those are really good. You just don't get a chance to play them. I could play it on an emulator anytime, but it's just so much more fun to play it here at home on the couch on my Super Nintendo or on my handheld. So I think that's pretty cool. And I'm just going to jump right into some gameplay footage. Alright, so I'm going ahead and jumping in here on the Retro Portable Duo version 2.0 for a couple of reasons. One, I don't have a whole lot of time today. I've got to go to work, and I'm editing a video that I'm shooting. It's a special video game Christmas film. And then two, you know, I've got a Retro Portable Duo version 2.0. Let me get this into focus. I got a RDP version 2.0 review online here, and I wanted to show people that you can play repros and you can play, actually this one, since this is all new, you can play new carts into the system, repros, newly programmed, whatever, it can play into the Retro Duo Portable. So you can see the gameplay here, very similar to maybe a Contra side-scrolling. It's, you know, very similar to Turrican on the Commodore, just much better graphics, much better music. Actually, I think the graphics work really well. I really like the graphics of this game for the Super Nintendo era, especially. It's very in line with Super Turrican. I like the graphics even better than Super Turrican. They look a little more detailed, I think. It's really cool, side-scrolling. And then after this stage, when you go to the next stage, it's kind of like Gradius. It's like R-Type. On some of those stages. So for that stage, I'm going to go ahead and switch to a more traditional view. I just wanted to show the Retro Duo Portable playing repro slash new programmed games on new card, new board, everything. But it does work on the Retro Duo Portable version 2.0, which is pretty cool. Some people ask about repro cards. Some people ask about different games. So here's this game on that. Brand new, cool game. Now I'm going to switch to a more traditional view. So here's this, you know, R-Type version, the space side-scrolling shooter, the space shooter, a lot like Gradius, Gradius 3, Super Nintendo, a lot like R-Type. You know, you got the same kind of pattern even as those games here, and you got the little, kill the little guys, the whole group of little guys, you get the upgrade for the certain little guys. You got the big groups, so yeah, and see, you got the little helpers that come flying out, just like on R-Type, but you can still get force fields, and the weapons are kind of cool here. It bounces around on the screen. That's kind of neat. Different, and you know, once you're fully upgraded your weapons, then the power-ups turn into points, because points are uber important. But yeah, so this is basically, you know, it's a quickie gameplay unboxing, let you look at it, and this is Targa for the Super Nintendo, now available in America thanks to Mr. Mark 0673. It's also right now on the front page of Nintendo Age, so you can click that link and check out Targa, see if you still got any copies left. It's pretty cool. Otherwise, appreciate the support always. Like and subscribe, and comment if you'd like. I'm working on a very special Christmas short film right now that I hate to give it a date, because every single time I've gave a date, I've never been able to keep it. So fingers crossed, December 23rd, I will have a brand new video game Christmas related film made, and that's what all this is about. So I can't wait to shave. But as soon as that is over with, I'm shot some of it, it's being edited, and I've got a little bit more to shoot next week, so hopefully it'll all be done, and so check back for that, and as always...